A very good morning, dear children. How are you all? Hope you all are fine. Be safe, children, and take care of yourselves. Today we are going to do a quick recap of the topic that we had discussed earlier, that is verb, and along with the verb, transitive and intransitive verb. So what do we mean by verb? We mean by verb that it is an action word, or it is a word that is used in the sentence to give full meaning to the sentence. Okay, so a verb completes an idea, can express an action or movement, and can give fulfillment to a sentence. So the verb, we can say, is the soul of the sentence. A sentence remains meaningless without the verb. With the use of the verb only, a sentence gets its full meaning. Now we come to verbs of being. Verbs, first of all, expresses the state of being. For example, Jamie was curious. So was is the verb which expresses the state of being. How was Jamie? She was curious. What is a state of being verb? There are 8 state of being verbs: is, am, are, was, were, and be, being, or been. So these are the 8 state of being verbs. Now, what is a state of being verb? A state of being verbs are often called linking verbs because they link the subject with the predicate. The subject of the sentence with the information available, they link the verb, the state of being verb links between the two. Some examples are, I am a student, you are my best friend, Ram is not at home, he has been here for 2 months. Smith is strange, Smith will always be my friend, Smith has been here for a week, Smith was away last week. So these all examples shows the state of being verb or state of existence. Okay, and some other verbs are have, has, have, or had. So what, where are the, when do we use these 3 verbs, has, have, and had? There are 3 conditions when we use these 3 verbs. One is to possess. They have a big house. I had a pet dog. He has a personal computer. Next, to eat or drink. I have my breakfast at 8 a.m. They are having their lunch. Please have dinner with us. And third, to do or to take. We had a lot of fun. He is having his bath. Grandmother is having rest. Clear? Now we come to that section of the verb where we understand it as an action word. All these are action words, so all these are verbs. Okay? Verbs. Verbs are doing or action words. Most people sleep at night, walk, don't run, says the teacher. Bianca ate her lunch, then played hopscotch. Will you remember school when you grow old? That burglar alarm has been ringing for 10 minutes. I will call the police. Now, object of the verb. Which is the object of the verb? The word which receives the action is called the object. Okay, so he paints posters. In this example, he is the subject as he is doing the work, performing the work. Paint is the verb as it expresses what work is being done or what action is being done. And posters is the object because the posters are receiving the action of the verb, that action. What does he paint? He paints the posters. So, Now let us come to objects. In addition to serving as subjects, noun may also function as object in sentences. So nouns can be used both as subjects and objects in a particular sentence. Instead of performing the action as subjects usually do, objects receive the action and usually follow the verb. So here the girls hurdled stones. So stones is the noun and it is following the verb. So this is the object. The professor swigged coffee. Say dropped the plate. So here we can see that the objects, these stones, coffee and plate, these three are the objects which has received the action of these words. Hurdle, swigged and dropped. Okay. Now we come to transitive and intransitive verb. What is a transitive verb? A transitive verb is that verb in which we have an object to receive the action. For example, I bake some cookies. So, what do I bake? I bake some cookies. Clear? Intransitive verb. In intransitive verb, there is no object to receive the action. They themselves are complete in meaning. Like I laugh, I cry, the book falls. Now whether transitive or intransitive? Transitive verb, Sarah baked a cake. Sarah baked what? A cake. So when we are able to answer a question from this sentence, statement, then that becomes a transitive verb. Nomi plays, that is an intransitive verb. Nomi plays with what or with whom? We have no answer. So that is an intransitive verb. Similarly, these are for some examples which we had already discussed yesterday. So you can just go through these examples and you can understand the difference between transitive and intransitive verb. Again, here we are here with some more examples. The words in green bold are verbs, transitive verbs, and the direct objects are the words in red. Okay. These are examples of intransitive verb, that is verb with no object. So please go through these examples. I have already explained everything to you. So go through these examples so that it becomes clearer to you. An intransitive verb does not have an object. However, it manages to express a complete thought without the help of other words. So look at the following sentences. Fire burns, the wind blows, birds fly. So they themselves are complete in meaning. Now let us see the following sentences. The girl seemed, the dog is. Both are incomplete, isn't it? They do not express a complete meaning, complete thought. So they are incomplete. So we need some words to complete these sentences. So we can say the girl seemed excited, the dog is hungry. So we are using adjectives in these sentences to complete the sentence or complete the meaning. The common verbs of incomplete predication are the forms of be verb, that is, am, are, was, are, were, seem, appear, look, become, feel and grow. So these are the examples, these are the common verbs of incomplete predication. Clear? So the complement of a verb of incomplete predication can be a noun, adjective or a pronoun, a present participle, a to infinitive or an adverb. So to complete an verb of incomplete, a sentence with a verb of incomplete predication, we can use either of these things, that is an adjective, a noun, a pronoun, a present participle, a to infinitive or an adverb. Okay, that's all. We have done a quick recap of the entire topic, that is verb and types of verb, that is transitive and intransitive verb. Okay, please go through the slides, listen to the slide, read it properly and complete the exercises that has been given to you. Okay, children, thank you.